Okay, let's go ahead and add a plane. With Ctrl A, apply the scale. Right click and subdivide. And increase fractal just to create an even terrain. I'm going to open the asset browser here to import the assets that I'm gonna use. Of course, you can use whatever you want, but you can download a free Natura asset pack on my Gumroad. Just drag and drop. I want to use the grass, also the flowers, and maybe some plants and rocks. If you want to scale the objects in object mode, make sure to apply the scale. Press Ctrl A, scale, and just in case, apply the rotation. Now I'm gonna organize the assets into collections. Just select them and press M. I'm gonna call it grass. And do the same for the other assets. We can hide the collections for now. I can use this material for the ground. Once we have the assets, let's go back to Geometry Nodes Editor. With the plane selected, click on New. Now Shift A and search for distribute points on faces. Also instance on points. And join geometry. Now connect geometry to join geometry so we can see the plane. Drag a collection into the editor. Connect to instance and make sure to enable pick instance. Now from here in distribute points, we can lower density. Also enable separate children and reset children. Now to change the scale, we can add a random value. And connect into scale. And here we can change from random to Poisson disk. This way we can control the minimum distance between objects. Now I'm going to use cycles for rendering. Also in world properties, I'm going to add a sky texture. Just lower the strength and play with rotation and elevation. Now in render properties, under film, click transparent to get rid of the background. Now with Shift D, duplicate random value. But this time we need to use vector, connect into rotation, and set maximum to 0. And now we can use the Z value for random rotation. If we need to add more objects, we can duplicate join geometry, also distribute points and instance on points. Now connect instance on points into the new join geometry. And we can bring the flower collection, connect to instance, also connect geometry to mesh. And we can duplicate random value for the scale. And don't forget to enable separate children and reset children. We can also duplicate random value for rotation. Now to add more objects, do the same, just duplicate the nodes. Just bring the new collection. Now let's see how to create node groups. So we can control the settings out of Geometry Nodes editor. For example, I want to control the grass density. From group input, connect to density max. And now we can see the option here. Now in this panel, click on group and we can rename it. And now we can adjust the grass density from here. We can create a new input for scale. Just connect to max in random value. For rotation, it's a little different, because we need random rotation, but only for the Z axis. So let's search for combine X, Y, and Z. Now connect to Z. Then connect to max in random value. Rename it. And now we have the random rotation, but only for the Z axis. And we can create new inputs for any option, for example, for distance or seat. So I'm going to create a new input for the flowers. Let's see scatter paint. With this method, we can paint the area where we want to scatter the objects using weight paint mode. So to do that, create a new input and connect into density factor. Rename it if you want. Now let's go to weight paint. In data, we need to create a new group. I'm gonna name it grass. Now in modifiers, click this button and select the group we just created. You can see there are colors. Blue means 0% weight. We can adjust the weight here, and red color 100% weight. We can also change the brush size in radius, or just hit F to change it. We can modify the strength. And we can also select different brushes, for example, subtract. Finally, let's see the proximity knot. For that, I'm gonna use this rock. Make sure to apply the scale. Go back to geometry nodes, but don't select the rock, select the plane. Now from the outliner, we can drag the rock into the editor. And search for geometry proximity. Connect the object from geometry to geometry in the proximity node. Now from distance, connect to scale. And we can add a map range. In object info, switch to relative. And as you can see, the grass around the rock has been scaled down. In map range, we can still adjust it. The problem is that random scale doesn't work now. So we can add a mat node. And connect random value. Also connect map branch and switch to multiply. And now random scale works again. But of course the flowers and rocks don't react to the effect, so we can duplicate the mat node. And connect the random value for the flowers to the first slot. And now map range to the second slot. And finally, the mat node into scale. And now it works with the flowers. And just need to do the same for the rocks.